We're now in orbit above Fallbrook, Captain.
Hey, got a favor to ask you. Next time we're out in the open sulfur, I'd like to stop in on an old friend of mine. Preferably before we get to Hiram's. It's on the way, don't worry. You don't seem the type to run off and get yourself killed, and I could use the help. I'll be up front with you. I hate asking for help. I hate it. Every time I give someone the opportunity to disappoint me, they seem to make it their most immediate goal. But this, what I'm thinking, it's dangerous. Really? Here I was steeling myself for inevitable rejection. I used to run with a band of hunters, friends, six of us. We were on Monarch when the corporations pulled out, and we helped a lot of people pick up the pieces. I haven't seen two of them in years. And the rest I know to be dead. I'd like to gather their effects and bury them all in the same places, like the family we once were. First, we go to Hayes. I buried him a ways from our encampment. I need to pay my respects. I'll show you where he rests. He had a medallion in his effects. That's what I'll bring home to bury. Then we find my two lost trackers and bring them home. A long time ago, we built an encampment in one of Monarch's cave systems. Trouble is, a mana queen showed up and kicked us all out. If we can find Rebecca and Anders, they'll know how to lure her out. Then, we kill the bitch and bury everyone's medallions together. Thanks, Cap.
always imagined Fallbrook would be...
You seen Arthur today?
You ever been off Monarch, Nyoka? Before you met the captain, I mean.
Nah, I mostly just drank and hunted. Soon as you stop to dream of other things, that'll be the day something sneaks up and eats you.
Don't fret, I'm watching your back now. Anything tries to eat us, I'll give it a mighty whack on the nose.
Well, I'll be damned. You watch my back, I'll watch yours.
Here they come!
Nice shot, Captain!
Nice one! Coming!
Thank you.
Hayes was the best self-sacrificing son of a saint I ever met. Halcyon is worse off without him. Now, if we're gonna lure the Manta Queen out, we'll need to find Rebecca and Anders. They took a UDL contract on Terra 2. We never heard from them again. Think it's time I call in a favor with Hiram. If anyone can track them down, it's him.
Incoming, Captain! Watch out!
Here we are. Told you we'd make it in one piece. The station ain't too far now. No. How the hell did marauders navigate the caverns?
Let's go!
Unexpected.
Thank you.
Attacking!
Hiram must have sealed the door. He spooks easy.
Realize this, being as you're an outsider, but the blaring alarms indicate the station's on lockdown. Which means you can't ever get to me. So leave already. Ready.
Can't. We'll see about that. Here's the elevator, but ain't gonna budge while this place is on lockdown. Guess we keep moving forward. Look for another way up.
can't tell if you're brave or simply touched in the head. What in the galaxy are you doing sniffing around my station? Unless you are, in fact, trying to suicide by marauder? And you, Nioka, what are you doing lugging a stranger into my station?
You could use the socialization, you son of a bitch. Also, he hired me.
To what purpose? I happen to have some significant problems I am dealing with right now. Marauders, running out of purple berry wine 3 days ago, not being able to bloody broadcast. No. We'll deal with information-related business later. As I said, there are bigger problems threatening my life and livelihood at this very moment. The Marauders want me dead. And since my hired hands have clearly turned idle, it appears I need you to clear out the threat. As my newest contractor, you may call me the Broker.
Or we can call you Hiram, on account of that's your damn name, and doubly on the account of the Broker being a dumbass alternative.
What? Everyone calls me that, aside from you. See, Nioka? I barricaded the broadcast center, but I can only hold out for so long. Clear the marauders out, and I'll pay you double the going rate. They destroy the transmission equipment, and I'll be out of business. The elevator and doors to the second floor are back online. Hurry before I have to lock them down again. Hey, elevators to your right. Get ready. That's the last of them, I think.
Never thought I'd be ecstatic at having the walls painted in blood, but seeing as it's not mine, I'd say this calls for a celebration. My compliments on your improvised utilization of the fire suppressant system. I would expect nothing less from one of Neoka's associates.
As usual, I'll take that as a compliment.
Of course. This ought to square our debt. One hefty payment for a highly valued service rendered. But, I admit, I do wonder why Neoka has brought you to me. Allow me to pose my question in another manner. Why, in the nebula, are you here? Oh, great. I love doing pro bono work for friends.
Aw, you called us friends. I'd normally entertain your self-aggrandizing delusions, but this time it's important.
Important to you is not the same as important to me. Although I do recognize that you may have earned some goodwill during your months laboring for me. Tug on my heartstrings, why don't you? Look, I'll do what I can, all right?
Rebecca Hodges and Anders Wadsworth. They took a UDL contract back when Monarch went to shit, and I need to find them. I believe them to be on Terra, too.
If UDL hired two hunters back then, it would have been for creature clearing purposes, round one of their Spacer's Choice outposts. These are the coordinates for the outpost under the last UDL contract. Now scram. And, good luck. Neoka, pick me up some stimu lotion and a bottle of purple berry wine when you're next in Stellar Bay.
Back for a rest? Space adventuring is tiring work.